If there's one thing we love here at CBR besides Spider-Man, it's trying to predict Marvel's next move. Of course, we're eagerly awaiting the release of Avengers 4, but that isn't the only new release we have to look forward to. Today, we're going to be talking about some upcoming films which are a little bit further down in the pipeline. Before we talk about what's coming next in the fourth phase of the MCU, be sure to subscribe to CBR and ring that gray bell to join our notification squad so you never miss any of our MCU videos. When Marvel released the first Iron Man movie, a lot was at stake. This was long before superhero movies had made it into the mainstream, and not only did Iron Man have to be an incredible standalone movie, but it had to set the stage for the Avengers. Since then, as we all know, we've had a deluge of awesome movies which have really fleshed out the Marvel Cinematic Universe. These films are grouped into several phases, which are just a convenient way to remember big events. Think of them like eras of prehistoric time, but with easier to remember names. Right now, we have two pending movies scheduled to be released during Marvel's third phase. Those are Avengers 4 and Captain Marvel. Obviously, we're over the top excited about both of these movies, but we can't help but wonder what's going to come next. Let's talk about the highly anticipated Phase 4. There's no denying that Avengers 4 is going to be a game changer of a film in many ways, and some of our favorite characters will be ending their long journeys. This might be the biggest catalyst for change in the history of the MCU, and we can't stop thinking about what comes next. Redditor Willis_17 had some interesting thoughts on the topic and posted some Phase 4 predictions. Now, Marvel predictions are a dime a dozen, but we found some evidence which may back up these claims. Let's start out with the movies we know will be getting released during this time period. So far, we know Spider-Man Far From Home and Guardians of the Galaxy Volume 3 will be parts of the fourth MCU phase. However, the latter has been delayed significantly due to the firing of director James Gunn. Only time will tell when we'll finally see our favorite Guardians back in action, and many fans wonder if this time around, we'll finally get to see the infamous Adam Warlock appearing in the MCU. Just like the previous phases, we're guessing we'll get a good mix of sequels to beloved characters and exciting new ones added to the lineup. Black Panther was a massive success, grossing over $1.3 billion at the box office, and yes, that's billion with a B. Director and co-writer Ryan Coogler has already signed on to work on the sequel, much to the delight of fans. But what may end up surprising fans is just who makes an appearance in the movie. During Black Panther, Michael B. Jordan's depiction of the villainous Killmonger was a massive success, but sadly, the character didn't survive that film. We're going to need new characters during the second movie, and we have a few of them in mind. Marvel Studios head Kevin Feige has been talking about bringing the superhero Moon Knight into the MCU. This character has no shortage of fans, and has dealings with the Black Panther in the comic books. Although Feige couldn't comment on when Moon Knight might appear, we would love to see him side by side with T'Challa. The only thing which gives us pause is that Moon Knight is a pretty dark, gritty character, even compared to the grim at times MCU. It's possible the studio may hold off on Moon Knight until they can give him the movie he deserves. Namor is another Marvel character who fans have been eager to see on the big screen. You could say he's Marvel's answer for the DC character Aquaman, but frankly, we think it's a bit insulting. Sure, they both command the sea, but Namor is a complex anti-hero, capable of both good deeds and horrific acts of vengeance. In the comics, he has been both a friend and foe of Wakanda, and the Black Panther at times. Some predict that there'll finally be a Namor movie during Phase 4, but the situation is a little bit complicated. Namor is one of the many great comic book characters caught up in a studio dispute. Marvel's Kevin Feige admits he's working on adding Namor to his library of superheroes, but these things unfortunately take time. Currently, the rights to the character belong to Universal Studios, but Feige is seeing if something can be worked out. He commented that Namor may be gradually integrated into the MCU, so instead of a standalone movie, it's possible Namor could show up during the upcoming Black Panther sequel. Another sequel we expect to see sometime in the near future is Doctor Strange 2. Stephen Strange is one of the few MCU superheroes not to have a sequel either completed or in the works. He just got caught up in Infinity War, and now the good doctor is a little bit preoccupied. But fear not, Strange fans, because Kevin Feige has confirmed another movie is in the works. Thanos has done many evil things, but perhaps the worst of which is keeping us from the sequel of Doctor Strange. Although Kevin Feige wouldn't comment on a possible release date, it does seem like a fairly safe prediction for Phase 4. Now, let's talk about a member of the Avengers who didn't even get a first movie yet. Black Widow. Hollywood seems to think Scarlett Johansson can play any role, but for some reason, they refused to give her a standalone Black Widow film. Ant-Man and the Wasp was the first time a female character even got to share the headline with a male character in the MCU, and that movie exceeded the revenue of the original. Black Widow is a great character, a founding member of the Avengers, and it's way past time she got her own movie. Most assume this movie will be a prequel, exploring the rarely quoted history of Natasha Romanoff. This could mean we'll see Natasha after the fall of the Soviet Union when she first gets involved with S.H.I.E.L.D. It seems likely we'll also see some other familiar Marvel characters, including both Hawkeye and Bucky Barnes. Another amazing female character getting her own movie is the unimitable Captain Marvel. Even before her movie hits theaters, Marvel is giving her a role to play during the fourth Avengers film. This says they have confidence in the character and that Captain Marvel will have a large role to play in the MCU. With this in mind, it doesn't sound inconceivable to think that a second Captain Marvel movie may come out during Phase 4. We think the list of Phase 4 predictions from Reddit is solid, but we're skeptical about the possibility of a Captain Marvel Annihilation movie. Comic book fans know that Annihilation is a storyline from the comic books which features a powerful villain, Annihilus. Anyone who has been eagerly keeping up with everything Avengers related also knows many people believe it will be the title of Avengers 4. Honestly, we think this makes more sense, since the Guardians of the Galaxy and Thanos were involved in the Annihilation storyline. It would seem odd to add Annihilation to a Captain Marvel movie, but we suppose stranger things have happened in the MCU. Without actually seeing Captain Marvel or the fourth Avengers movie, we don't think we can predict what Captain Marvel 2 would be about yet. Marvel Studios head Kevin Feige is always happy to hand out promising bits of information with frustratingly few details. When discussing the Marvel Cinematic Universe following Phase 3, he mentioned the Eternals comic books. According to Feige, it's more than just an idea at this point, and the studio has been actively beginning to have creative discussions about bringing them into the MCU. Feige admitted to no one's surprise that Avengers 4, Captain Marvel, and Spider-Man Far From Home are occupying the bulk of the studio's time and efforts. But this doesn't mean they aren't also thinking about the future. In addition to coming up with the sequels, the MCU needs a constant influx of new characters in order to stay interesting and competitive. The Eternals were created by Jack Kirby, who also had a hand in creating some amazing Marvel characters, including the Fantastic Four, the X-Men, and the Incredible Hulk. The Eternals are an evolutionary offshoot of human beings, who were created by the cosmic entities known as the Celestials. These beings are immensely old and immeasurably powerful. During Guardians of the Galaxy Volume 2, we learn that Peter Quill's father, Ego, was one of these Celestials. The Celestials enjoy, well, playing God and accelerated evolution in some subjects. This left the Eternals with an impressive array of superpowers. While the Eternals use their powers for good, their counterparts, the Deviants, use them for evil. If you've ever wondered what a hybrid of an Eternal and a Deviant would look like, look no further than our good friend Thanos. We all know we can't get enough of the Mad Titan, but we mention him as an example of the sort of power wielded by the Eternals. They would definitely be an exciting addition to the MCU, and would really shake things up during Phase 4. Another addition which would change the MCU dramatically would be the Fantastic Four. Sure, we've seen them on the big screen before, but never as a part of the MCU. For a long time, the licenses to these characters were with 21st Century Fox, but they'll be overseen by Marvel Studios as early as 2019. We can't wait to see them join our existing cast of heroes, but we also wonder how they'll appear to fit together with all of the existing moving pieces. Marvel Studios plans its movies out years in advance, and it's easy to see why, because of the sheer amount of complex parts and characters. As much as we would love to see the Fantastic Four, and heck, even the X-Men as part of the MCU, this process could take a long time. The merger won't even be totally complete until September 2019, so we're skeptical that a Fantastic Four movie could make it into the already jam-packed Phase 4 of the Marvel movies. We're still hung up on the tragic ending of Avengers Infinity War, but we're trying to hold out hope for Avengers 4. There's no denying this movie is going to be a massive game changer, and we'll be losing at least one of our favorite heroes. This is going to mean there'll be lots of room in the MCU for new characters. In fact, some fans have already started to talk about the fifth movie in the Avengers franchise, despite the fact that the title of the fourth movie hasn't even been confirmed. Of course, at this point, we can't do more than speculate and hang on to every word of people in the know. So that's precisely what we're gonna do. According to Disney CEO Bob Iger, the Marvel team is already talking about the future of the Avengers. We weren't kidding when we said earlier that these things are planned out years in advance. Iger confirmed the team is about a new franchise beyond Avengers, but added that this doesn't mean we've seen the last of the Avengers, or what's left of them. And that's what we think is going to happen in Phase 4 of the MCU. What are your predictions for the upcoming phase? Let us know which movies you're most looking forward to in the comments section below, and then click on the subscribe button for the latest MCU videos from CBR. Thanks for watching.